Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another edition of Masterpiece Theater. Tonight's story is a wonderful tale about a young woman's quest for Greek knowledge. Let us begin, shall we? This adorable child is the heroine of the story. I would like you to meet Robin. She and her mother are visiting their aunt in the country where there is no cell phone reception, internet, or cable. School is out for the summer, and she's a bit bored, you see?
Hi, I'm Robin. I'm a bit bored, you see.
But that is about to change.
Robin, Robin!
I'm over here, Mother.
Oh, there you are, Robin. I've been looking all over for you.
What are you doing?
Solving the world's problems by seeing how many links it takes to get to the Chelsea World Center of Pop.
I'm sorry, dear. What was that?
Guess the world will never know.
Nothing. I'm not doing anything.
Good.
So your aunt Sam needs you on a little errand for her.
Right now?
Yes, right now.
Right this very second?
Yes, right this very second.
But Mom!
Don't but Mom me. You just sit here and do anything. That's what you do.
Grumble, grumble, grumble.
Okay, fine. What do I need to do?
So your aunt Sam needs you to pull both from Sue's errands over on Olympiad Street.
One bolt?
Yes.
Just one bolt?
Yes.
Gee, not sure I can handle this task.
I know you're poor, Robin, but no one's going to be smart with me.
I'm sorry, Mom.
Good. No, I think you're going.
Mom?
Yes?
How do I get to Olympiad Street?
How do I get to Olympiad Street?
Why, follow the Yellow Brick Road, of course.
Follow the Yellow Brick Road?
What Yellow Brick Road? Are you serious?
No, silly. I'm kidding.
Ha ha ha.
Go straight down the path and take a right at the rock.
You can't miss it.
Take a right at the rock.
Okie dokie.
Bye bye bye.
That girl definitely needs a pitcher. Hopefully they were a little excited for once.
Oh, it's time to be breathless.
I wonder if Victor's up today.
Saying something about it in class, but
focused on all the penguins in the room. So, maybe I wasn't paying attention.
What? How can the Trojan War have been a long time ago when it's going on right now? How can this girl not know the Trojan War is going on right now? It's 12th century BC. Kids need to stop painting graffiti on cave walls and pay more attention to the world around them.
Yeah, this dude is nuts.
You seem rushed and a bit crazy, so I won't take up any more of your time. Can you tell me if this is the way to get to Olympiad Street?
You're going to Olympiad Street?
Yes, I need to get a bolt for my NTM at Seuss and Eris.
You're going to Seuss and Eris on Olympiad Street?
Yes. I am going to Seuss and Eris over on Olympiad Street. Now you want to think about wearing earplugs. Your hearing seems to be going.
That's wonderful!
How is hearing loss wonderful?
Not that! Achilles is fighting 5 blocks past Seuss and Eris on Meter Boulevard. Can you take the medal to him?
Well, if I ever figure out how to get to Olympiad Street, I will.
Oh, yeah, you wanted directions. Well, you just keep going down that street and take a right at the rock. Can't miss it.
Thanks.
So you'll take the medal to Achilles? Will you?
All right, I'll do it. Please consider laying off the caffeine.
Thanks a million, Robin! Bye!
Bye!
Wait! Oh, forgot to warn her about the danger at the rock! Man, I really need to pick up some ginkgo biloba.
Now, where did I put my hammer?
Robin once again set forth on her journey. The next person Robin met was Demeter, who's tending her farm.
God's Demeter had a farm, D-E-T-E-R, and on that farm she had some pigs. D-E-T-E-R, there's another one here, and another one there, and another one here, and I give her one at the God's Demeter had a farm, D-E-T-E-R.
Excuse me, Miss Demeter. Demeter?
No, my name is Demeter, and I'm the goddess of agriculture.
Oh, I see. What a weird name. My name's Robin.
Robin, that's a bird.
No, Robin, as in Batman and Robin. Apparently, my parents thought it'd be cool to name a kid after a short, geeky guy in tights.
Oh, I see. Nice name choice. Anywho, what things do you know really about Robin?
I'm on my way to Seuss and Eris to get a bolt. Homo Stasis said to take this road until I come to a big rock and then turn right. Does that sound right to you?
Yeah. That's okay. I'm going out though. Well, is there a rush? Do you have a few minutes? Would you like to see my farm? I found some snakes and pigs. They're my favorite.
That's as weird as your name. No thanks. I'm sure Auntie Anne is waiting for me to get back with that bolt. It was nice meeting you.
It was nice meeting you too. Be careful of crow.
What was that? I can't hear you. I wonder if she means provolone. No worries there. I hate cheese.
Once again continues on her journey singing her favorite song.
What does the fox say?
Catchy tune, huh? Oblivious to her surroundings, she runs into a giant rock.
Ow! Hey! Watch where you're going!
Who said that?
I did! Over here!
Oh, sorry about that. I didn't know anyone else was here.
It's okay. Happens all the time. Prometheus at your service. I'd shake your hand, but I'm a bit detained at the moment.
I'm Robin. How about I give you a high five instead?
pet dog for every time someone asks me that question, I could buy a million livers.
What is that supposed to mean? Is it supposed to be funny? Because I don't get it.
What? My story is legendary. Are you from out of town or something?
Actually, I am.
Oh, then you don't know. I suppose telling this story one more time won't kill me. Well, Robin, I spent most of my life taking care of the people, giving them what they need. One day, I noticed they needed fire. Let's just face it, it's not hard to cook and keep warm on those cold nights.
It's 104 outside.
Will you let me finish my story?
Okay, sorry.
So, I took Fire from one place and gave it to the people. But you see, the fire belonged to Zeus, and I took it without asking. So I chained me to this rock. Every day, an eagle visits me and pecks on my liver, and every day, my liver grows back. It's a vicious cycle.
Let's knock on the door for a count of three.
Robin is my name. Please tell me yours, you scary man of fame.
I am Hades, king of the underworld, and I order you to stop speaking rhyme. You do not look like a poet, so you do not need to speak like one. It's bad enough having to listen to this guy right outside my door what feels like forever and a day.
Thank goodness. That rhyming was starting to get annoying and contagious.
All right, why don't you both come in and we'll talk about terms of agreement.
So, what brings you to this neck of the underworld, Robin?
I'm going to Olympiad Street to get a bolt for my NCM and to deliver this medal to Achilles before he goes into another battle.
Achilles, say? Interesting. I have an appointment with him later today, but that is another matter. Let's bring out the focus of this journey. Oh, you're in a sea, come hither.
Enter Hades.
Dear Eurydice, what is wrong with you? You look like you have a bad case of the flu.
There's no passing, Orpheus. Besides, she won't respond to you. She's part of my role now. If you want her back, you'll have to sing her out on one condition.
A stipulation. I wonder what it could be. But I will do whatever it takes to bring Eurydice back to me.
Okay, Orpheus, here's the deal. You will lead your Eurydice out of the underworld, safe all the way. But if you look back for any reason, your seat is in her mind forever. This is one small thing. You have to sing this tune.
That shouldn't be difficult, as I can see.
Are you ready to go, Eurydice?
She only talks to me, Orpheus, Eurydice, and your survey.
I need you to follow Orpheus, Eurydice. On the way, you are allowed to speak without permission, but you can only speak sounds, not words. Do you understand, Eurydice?
Yes, Hades.
Are you ready to go, Eurydice?
Yes, Hades.
Robin, was a pleasure meeting you.
Bye. All right, Orpheus, time to loosen up your voice box so you can save your little fox.
I better be a guardian.
My name is Hermes. Welcome to Hasta la Vista Travel.
Hey,
Hey, stop shaking my hand now.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Business has been kind of slow lately.
No need to apologize. Did you say your name was Hermy? Like the elf that wanted to be a dentist?
No, Hermes, like the god of travel. Well, not like. I am the god of travel.
Oh, well, good for you. You'd think you'd have more business being the god of travel and all.
Yeah, well, the recession affects us all.
Okay. Anyway, since you are the god of travel, you can help me get to Olympiad Street, right?
Olympiad Street? Out of all the beautiful places in the world, why would you want to get to Olympiad Street?
A guy whose name sounds like a sneeze wanted me to take this medal to Achilles.
Hephaestus?
Isn't I? And I need to get a bolt for my NPM.
Can you help?
One moment, please. I believe my business partner can.
Pete? Sidon Sea Cruises? What kind of a name is Sidon? Canadian?
It's not Sidon, it's Sidon with a long I. But about that, his name really isn't Pete, you see.
Cowabunga, dude, someone hates that.
Cowabunga, this is Robin. She needs a ride to Olympiad Street.
How do you do, Pete?
Pete, Hermie, you didn't tell her my real name. If she's going to Olympiad Street, she should know my real name. You know, Pete is just for tourists.
Well, I was about to, but then you burst in with all that surfer getup.
Hey, that's what the sea trouble makes you do.
Well, dude, why don't you tell her your real name?
Okay, dude, I will. Robin, my name is Poseidon.
Poseidon? Yeah, maybe you should stick with Pete.
Listen, dude, if I were mortal, I would. But I'm Poseidon, god of the sea.
God of the sea? I'm not sure if you've noticed, dude, but there's no water to be found. So god of the sea you are. No wonder business is slow. No one wants to take a sea cruise if there is no sea.
Listen here, Robin. Let me take care of the water, okay? Now you said you want to get to Olympiad Street, right?
Yes.
Okay, please, please set up Robin's travel arrangements.
Gladly. If you can take a seat, Robin, we can get started. Now, how exactly would you like to get to Olympiad Street?
What are my options?
Go ahead, ask all of you to travel and beat side sea cruises. We only deal with water travel.
Everybody's going surfing.
Of course, because Pete Sidon only deals with water, except there is no water.
It's Poseidon, and water is getting like the whole god of the sea thing.
Then why don't you change the sign to Poseidon Sea Cruises?
Between you and me, that's what I wanted. But the sign made you guys misunderstood Poseidon, or Pete Sidon. When I saw the sign, I wanted a tidal wave to come and take out his business. But I felt bad for him. He used to be an elf at the North Pole and left to be a dentist. He would have been successful until he had removed him from the abominable snowman.
The abominable snowman? Did he hurt him?
No, he did a good job. In fact, too good. The abominable snowman wanted him to be his personal dentist only. Scared off any other future patients. The only business he could get was sign making.
His name, by chance, wouldn't be Hermie, would it?
Yes. Yes, it is.
You know him? Only from television. Can we get back to the travel plans, please?
Of course. Now what form of water transportation do you prefer? We have rafts, canoes, surfboards, fishing boats, and cruise ships.
Well, what do you prefer?
I highly recommend the cruise ship.
Then cruise ship it is.
Excellent. You'll love the SS Minnow. Now, the skipper and Galligan are on a vacation on some desert island, but Captain Poseidon will be in command.
Our Captain Poseidon, not yet, sir.
Is he serious?
Yeah, he thinks he's a pirate whenever he goes out on the cruise, but it's better than the surfer motif.
Move along, but I'm gonna have you walk the plank.
Go ahead, Robin. You'll be in good hands.
Welcome aboard the SS Minnow. I hope we're ready for the return. Just kidding. My friend is here. So follow.
Let me guess. You're gods too?
Yes, we are. I'm the god of morning.
And I'm the god of music. And you are?
Robin. Just Robin.
Welcome, Miss Robin. Or maybe it's time to button down the hatches and show us.
I'll take help people look for love?
Of course I can, for I am the goddess of love.
It seems like everyone around here is a god or a goddess or something.
What did you expect? You're on your way to Olympiad today. Ask again. Are you looking for love, Robin?
No, but I think Narcissus here could use your help.
Ah, yes, Narcissus. What can we do for you, Narcissus? Do you need a little help in the love department?
I hate to say it, but such as I'm so good looking.
But yes, I do need help. Finding love that's as beautiful as I am. Can you help? I certainly can. I shall touch your shoulders and love shall be yours.
What is this? My, you are gorgeous. You look familiar. Have I seen you around?
Oh no, this has never happened before.
What?
Narcissus has fallen in love with himself.
What is that, my love? It looks like you're trying to say something. Let me get closer so I can hear you.
Oh no, Narcissus, that's not a good idea. It's not what you think.
Yes, it is. It's true love, Aphrodite.
Wait for me. Please don't leave. I love you! No! This calls for a song. There once was a man named Narcissus. He was a man that had many wishes. Found his true love, flew in the air like a duck, that ended up swimming with the fishes. Very cool. Come on, Aphrodite. You could use one of Dionysus' mangoes and cucumber smoothies.
Poor Narcissus fell into the water with the fishes, all because he couldn't stop looking at his reflection. Vanity is a terrible thing, but on the bright side, a wonderful song came out of all of this. No, I'm not referring to Apollo's song. I'm referring to Carly Simon's wonderful hit, You're So Vain. That song really is about him. But back to our heroine. Robin walked along the deck of the ship where she spotted two individuals intensely playing a game.
B7.
S.
R.
H4.
Hey, you sunk my battleship.
And let me game again. Whoop, there it is.
That is the 1,278th game in a row that you've won. How do you do it?
How the goddess of this battle strategy. What did you expect?
That the god of war would actually win?
And you would win if you followed their battle strategy.
Leave it to a woman to tell a man what to do.
Hi there.
Hark, who goes there?
Someone unarmed.
What's that in your hand?
It's just a piece of metal. I need to deliver it to Achilles.
Achilles, you must be going to Olympiad Street.
Yes, I am.
Well, Robin, I'm Athena, and that's Ares. It was a pleasure meeting you.
Since Robin clearly isn't a threat, how about a rematch?
Right now, aren't you tired of losing at battleship? You think you will be after 1,279 times.
1,278 times, and I'm not giving up until I win.
Not now, Ares.
How about a game of horses?
But you know I'm not very good at that game.
Oh. Don't recall that.
Well, if we're going to play, let's make it interesting. How about the loser watches the winner's chores for a year?
That's tempting. How about the loser does the winner's chores for a year?
Well, I don't know. It's a big gamble.
Come on, Athena. Don't be a chicken.
Well.
Cough, 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 cough.
Okay, so that goes to Athena. Woo-hoo. Going to demolish him.
But I thought you said you weren't very good.
That was all part of my plan. This is a game of battle strategy, and I'm the goddess of battle strategy. He's going down. It was nice to meet you, Robin, but I gotta run.
Wow, a lot of strange people have been on this journey. I wonder when I'll get to Olympiad Street.
Arr, those you swaps that lived in the living between the Bay Street. We'll be there in 2 minutes, so grab your bay treasure. And for those of you who can't wait that long, they'll be walking on the plank on the starboard side. And thank you for sailing with Pete's Sight and Sea Cruises. Oh.
Olympiad Street. Robin walked until she came across.
but he stole fire from me, and that's unacceptable. Sure, I understand why he did it. The people could benefit from fire. But he didn't ask. All he had to do was ask. I would have gave him the fire. Well, maybe I would have. But still, he didn't have.
Shh, Zeus, why don't you take care of it?
You lick it and stuff it and go back to sleep.
But Zeus stuck its foot!
Listen to me. Robin already knows me now, so there's no need to act tough in front of her. She won't tell you she can.
Will you, Robin?
Absolutely not. No one will believe me anyway.
Okay. But before I go, here's what you need for your auntie. It's not Z-shaped, but the Z's similar to lightning. And only I can handle lightning.
All right. Thanks, Zeus.
I guess I have everything I need. Sorry I couldn't get the medal to Achilles in time. Come to think of it, Hades did say he had an appointment with us later today.
It's okay, Robin. Everything is as it should be.
Except for one thing. How do I get home?
You click your heels 3 times and say, there's no place like home, there's no place like home.
Seriously?
No! I was making a joke with your aunt and auntie, and I thought you would get the humor. Okay. What you need to do to get home is close your eyes and count to 10. When you open your eyes, you will be back home.
And so, Robin closed her eyes, counted to 10. When she woke up, she was back at home with a book about Greek mythology in her hand. Her mother was there calling her name.
Robin, wake up, sleepy head.
I'm home.
Of course you're home, dear. You didn't go anywhere.
Of course I did. You sent me to Zeus and Eros to get a book for Auntie Em.
Zeus and Eros? Wow, that book of Greek mythology really has. Wait, you mean I didn't go anywhere?
Of course not, dear.
No, I didn't get washed up. Dinner will be ready in 10 minutes.
Huh.
I guess it was all a dream.
But just as Robin was about to leave, she heard someone singing.
Now, tell me what's going on.
Well, things were getting a little cooped up in the house,
Water. Please let me in.
This wolf is never going to be mine.
Glass of water and a Kleenex, please.
Have a seat.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Now, who are you?
Phoebe Wolf. But before you asked, I am not the big fat.
I can tell by your puffy, watery eyes. My name's Porkus and Beans, but everyone calls me Pork.
Really? They call you Pork and Beans?
Yeah, but Beans up with a Z.
That's funny.
What is?
Oh, nothing. Don't mean to be rude or anything, but I asked for a Kleenex. Do you have any?
Yeah, just a sec. Here you go.
Thank you.
If you don't mind my asking, why are you crying?
I accidentally blew down a house made of straw down the road.
A house made of straw? That's my brother's. I told him not to build a house out of straw. I told him it would blow down. But did he listen? No. How did you blow it down anyway?
Well, I'm allergic to straw, and I sneezed, and it fell down.
Is Ham okay?
I don't know. I couldn't find him.
Calm down. I'm sure he's fine. Ham had a similar experience with the Jolly Green Giant. He bet the giant three magic beans that he couldn't whistle the theme song to the Andy Griffith Show. As soon as the giant began to whistle, he blew Ham right in the next Tuesday.
That's funny. Thanks for trying to cheer me up.
No, seriously. We couldn't find him until the next Tuesday.
Oh.
I'm sure he'll turn up. He always does.
Aren't you afraid I'm gonna blow down your house, too?
Of course not. This house is made out of sticks from the mighty papier-mâché oak tree. Nothing's gonna blow this thing down. Now why don't you quit your crying and blow that big nose of yours?
Okay.
Thank you.
plaintiff, Frances, Frank, and Beans. She claims the defendant blew down her brother's houses after they refused to let him in, but here's their chins, and then ate her brothers after blowing down their houses. She is suing for $10,000 for the price of the destroyed homes and the amount of money she would have gotten for her brothers at the Williams County Fair. This is defendant B.B. Wolf. He claims he only continued to knock on the Beans brothers' doors because he needed a glass of water and a Kleenex. He is suing for $5,000 for the price of the medical visit because of the allergic reaction to the straw, which led to the demise of both houses. He is accused of spilling the beans.
All right, John, your parts presiding.
You may be seated. Sleepy, wake up or it's off with your head.
Oh, sorry, your cardiac kindness.
It's the Queen of Hearts. Get it right, or it's off with your head.
Mm-hmm.
Sleepy Swordsman.
Raise your right hand. I mean Paul. Whatever. Wait a minute. Is that the right one? Hey, that is right. Okay, repeat it after me. I state your name.
I state your name.
Do solemnly swear.
To tell the truth.
And nothing but the truth. So the Queen of Hearts does not chop off my head. Alright, good. You may put your appendages down now. It's nap time.
It's so hard to find good help these days.
That's what she gets for hiring.
Sleepy. I'm surprised
they
awake this long.
The sky is falling.
Silence, birds. Off with your heads.
Well, I'm glad you both are okay, but what about about your houses? I have to do something to make up for that.
Yeah, well, the sky's falling because the sky is falling. You need shelter.
Jake, stop your clucking. The sky is not falling. I think I have an idea for the housing problem. You two can stay with me and my six brothers. We don't have any extra beds, but we have plenty of blankets. Snow White wouldn't mind if we had a couple pigs in a blanket.
Great. Pigs in a blanket sounds divine.
Come on, let's go. It's almost time for my third nap.